For this lesson, you need to open the World Sales 4 sample file from your Sample Files folder. In this lesson, we'll explore using subtle shadows and 3D formats to add a professional sheen to your work. I'll begin by selecting the chart by clicking just inside the border. And now I'm going to select the chart title element. To do this, I'll click Chart Tools Format on the ribbon, and on the left you can see there's a Current Selection group. At the top of the Current Selection group, there's a Chart Elements drop-down. If I click the drop-down, you can see all of the chart elements that currently exist on this chart. I'm going to click the Chart Title element, and when I click, the Chart Title element is selected. Up to now, you've selected elements simply by clicking on them. So, why would you want to use the Chart Elements drop-down? Well, directly clicking on an element is usually faster, but there are some chart elements, such as grid lines, that can sometimes be difficult to select with the mouse. If you do a lot of work with charts, you might want to add the Chart Elements drop-down list to the Quick Access toolbar. This was covered in Lesson 114. To do this, you'd right-click on the Chart Title Elements list and then select Add to Quick Access toolbar from the shortcut menu. It's then very easy to select chart elements simply by selecting them in the Quick Access toolbar. But I'll remove that now from the Quick Access toolbar. Next, we'll bring up the Format Title task pane. Now, previously, you did this by right-clicking and selecting Format Chart Title from the shortcut menu. And that's usually the fastest and most convenient way. But let me show you a different way. With the Chart Title element selected, on the Chart Tools Format ribbon, in the Current Selection group, you can see that one of the options is Format Selection, and that does exactly the same thing. It brings up the Format Chart Title task pane. The first thing I'm going to do is to add a shadow to the Chart Title element. To do that, I'll click the Effects icon in the Format Chart Title task pane, and one of the flyout menu options is Shadow. So I click Shadow and the flyout menu appears. Now, it would be possible to create your own shadows using the transparency, size, blur, angle and distance sliders, but you'll probably find that presets are a better way. The advantage of using presets is that you'll have uniformity between different chart elements that you might apply shadows to. So I'll click the Preset button, and I'm going to select the Offset Diagonal Bottom Right preset. That will place a subtle shadow on the right-hand side and the bottom of the chart title element. So I click the Preset, and if I click on a different element, you can see how that's been applied to the chart title element. Now I'm going to apply a 3D effect to the chart title element, specifically a circle top bevel effect. Bevel effects make an element look a little like a button. So once again, I'll bring up the Format Chart Title task pane, and I'll click the Effects button. And this time I'll open up the 3D Format flyout menu. Just like shadows, you'll probably find what you need in the 3D presets rather than creating your own custom 3D effects. So I'm going to click the Top Bevel preset, and I'll select the Circle Bevel preset. When I click, the Bevel effect is applied to the Chart Title element. I'll just click on a different element so I can see that more clearly. And you can see that the element now appears to be a little like a button. Now, I've added a lot of fancy formatting to the chart title element, but I haven't really improved the appearance of the element. Excel provides a Reset to Match Style feature, which enables you to restore elements back to their original state. So I'll click on the Chart Title element to select it, then it's Chart Tools on the ribbon and Format, and in the Current Selection group you can see the Reset to Match Style button. I'll click Reset to Match Style and all of the formatting is removed, and the Chart Title element is restored to its default state. I'll now close the Format Shape task pane by clicking the Close button at the top right corner. And all that remains for this lesson is to save your work. And I'm going to save with the new name, World Sales 5. And as usual, I'll save to the folder above, my Sample Files folder. I click the Save button, and you've now completed Lesson 5.8, Format 3D Elements and Add Drop Shadows.